हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबडी. वंस अगेन इट्स मी ओम प्रकाश. इन द लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट प्रोनाउन. ओके, सो टुडे बिफोर वी कंटिन्यू विद द रिमेनिंग टाइप्स ऑफ प्रोनाउन्स, लेट अस ट्राई टू रिकलेक्ट व्हाट ऑल वी रेड इन अवर प्रीवियस क्लास. प्रोनाउन, ओके, व्हाट इज अ प्रोनाउन? प्रोनाउन्स आर द वर्ड्स दैट आर यूज्ड इंस्टेड ऑफ ए नाउन. ओके, आई रिपीट, pronouns are the words that are used instead of a noun. And generally, why do we use a pronoun here? Because they avoid repetition of nouns. Okay, pronouns avoid the repetition of nouns. Yesterday I have given you a small example. If I want to speak about a person, then there is no problem of using a noun there. But instead, if I want to speak for some 5 to 10 nouns, if I want to speak about some 10 students' names, then it becomes difficult for me to use the nouns continuously. So that is the reason why we use pronouns. Okay, for example, I said Ram is a good boy. Okay, and Ram is a clever student in the class. Ram scores 98%. In all these three cases, continuously I am using Ram. So in this case, it's not a difficult situation for me, it's not a task for me to repeat the noun. But let us say there are some 10 students in the class, they are also as clever as Ram, they also score 98%, they are also very good. So what is going to happen if I'm going to speak about these 10 students' name? It is going to become a little bit problematic. All right, continuously I cannot say like Ram, Shyam, Rahul, Dravid, Ali. All right, are good students. Ram, Shyam, Rahul, David, Ali score 98%. All right, continuously I can't use the nouns here because it is going to take a lot of time for me. So that is the reason why, to avoid these nouns, I use pronouns. All right, like some of the examples yesterday we discussed, pronouns: I, he, she, you, me, they. These are the simple pronouns which we use in our day-to-day life. All right. So if we are going to use these pronouns, we are going to save some time. And even if it is a writing task, we are going to use only little bit of our efforts to complete the task. All right. If not, if you want to use the nouns, then it is going to take a lot of time for you to write. So that is the reason why here the definition says pronouns are the words used instead of nouns, and we can say pronouns avoid a repetition of nouns. All right. Now, even in the previous class, we discussed different types of pronouns. So here I have written here. All right. Types of pronouns. So how many types of pronouns do we have? Like 9 types. All right. There are 9 types of pronouns are there. Now, first one, what are we going to call? It's a personal pronoun. Second one, possessive pronoun. Third one, reflexive pronoun. Fourth one, emphatic. Fifth one, demonstrative. Sixth one, distributive. Seventh one, interrogative. Eighth one, reflexive. And the 9th one is a reciprocal pronoun. Okay? So these are the 9 types of pronouns we have. Now let us see what is the difference between in all these pronouns. First one, dear, personal pronoun. Yesterday, like in the previous class, we discussed I, he, she. These are the 3 words comes under personal pronoun. Okay, I, he, she. These are the 3 pronouns which comes under personal pronoun. Yesterday we discussed, in the previous class we discussed about this. And coming to the second one, possessive pronoun. Possessive pronoun is nothing but speaks about the ownership. Okay, even we discussed about this in our previous class. Possessive pronoun speaks about the ownership, like mine, yours, hers, theirs. All right, these are the words comes under possessive pronoun. Okay, and coming to the next one, reflexive pronoun. Reflexive pronoun is nothing but when we say myself, yourself, herself, himself, themselves. When we use these self words, all these comes under reflexive pronoun. All right, and the same words are also comes under this emphatic pronoun. Now, what is the difference between then reflexive and emphatic? Yesterday, I have shown you an example here. All right, I am writing example for both this reflexive and emphatic. Now, let us see. Now, look at these two examples. She prepared herself. All right. This is also a pronoun and this is also a pronoun. All right. And here this pronoun is referring back to this main pronoun. So, in this case, when this pronoun is referring back to this main pronoun, then we are going to call this as our reflexive pronoun. But whereas if you look at this, this is a pronoun and this is also a pronoun. One pronoun is followed by the other. This is emphasizing on this pronoun. So that is the reason why in this case we are going to call this as our emphatic pronoun. All right. This is a small difference between our reflexive and emphatic. Okay. In the first case, this is a pronoun and this is a pronoun. This is referring back to this pronoun. So that is the reason why we are going to call this as a reflexive pronoun. But whereas in this case, one pronoun is followed by the other and this is emphasizing on this pronoun. So that is the reason why in this case, we are going to call it as an emphatic pronoun. All right. Now coming to the next one, dear, demonstrative. Okay. Now coming to the demonstrative pronoun, demonstrative, it means demonstrating. You might have seen on the roadside, all right, some of them, they will keep some of the, water purifiers, all right, vacuum cleaners, cars, two-wheelers, or any new products which are launched in the market. All right, let us say you have visited that place. And the person is speaking in English. All right, the executive over there is speaking in English. Let us say in the market, he has kept a pen. All right, he has kept one pen here and one pen over there, and he is giving the demonstration. So he uses what type of words here? This pen is made in Germany. That pen is made in another country name. You can say US. All right, if the products are more, these, those, they. Okay, these are the words which comes under demonstrative pronouns. This, that, these, those, they. These are the words, these are the pronouns which comes under demonstrative pronouns. Okay, and coming to the next one, distributive pronoun. Each, either, neither. These are the three pronouns which comes under distributive pronoun. And coming to the next one, interrogative. The name itself is saying interrogative means asking questions. So when you ask questions, generally we use WH words. All right. Like what, where, whose, when, whom, how. These are all nothing but our interrogative pronouns. What, where, when, whom, how, all the WH words that comes under interrogative pronoun. Now coming to the reflexive, I'm sorry dear, already I have written here reflexive. Now coming to the next one is indefinite pronoun. Indefinite, which is not sure. When we are not sure, we use some words here, and those words we are going to consider as indefinite pronouns. For example, now if you look at this sum, not sure, few, little, more, much, these are all nothing but our indefinite pronouns. Okay, and coming to the last one, reciprocal pronoun. Okay, reciprocal pronoun, that is nothing but reciprocal pronoun is nothing but one another, each other. These are the two pronouns we are going to consider under reciprocal pronoun. Okay, and coming to the next one, dear, and the last one, we are going to call it as like who, which, that. All right, so these are also nothing but our relative pronouns. The thing here is, let us say all the WH words, I say who, which, also comes under this interrogative pronoun. Then how to identify whether it is an interrogative pronoun or a relative pronoun? Now here, relative pronouns are used to combine two small sentences or clauses which are related to each other. All right, relative pronouns are used to combine two clauses or sentences which has some relationship, connection here, by using these pronouns. Example, now look at this example. The person standing there is my uncle and he is a doctor. All right, this has got some relationship with this and this has got some relationship with this. It means these two sentences have some sort of relationship. So now instead of using these two sentences, what I'm going to do is I'm going to combine these two sentences by using any of this relative pronoun. So here, let me use this. Here, the person who is standing there is my uncle. Comma, here you can say he is a doctor. All right, so here I am using who. In the same way, we can use which and that. All right, so just to combine two clauses or two sentences using these relative pronouns when we combine. All right, they are used for combining two sentences or clauses by using these pronouns, then we are going to call them as relative pronouns. Okay, So these are the different types of pronouns we have here. Okay, so before we wind up, let us try to understand. Pronoun is nothing but those are the words that are used instead of nouns. Okay, and pronouns avoid repetition of nouns. And types of pronouns here, like we have personal pronoun. Okay, personal pronoun is nothing but I, he, she. Generally we use these three words under this personal pronoun. And coming to the possessive pronoun, possessive pronoun speaks about the ownership. All right, ownership is nothing but here mine, yours, theirs, hers. We can use these words for possessive pronoun. And coming to the reflexive pronoun, reflexive pronouns are nothing but the words ending with self, I, myself, yourself, herself, themselves. So even the same pronouns can be used under emphatic. All right, reflexive and emphatic both are same, but the thing is we need to identify whether it is reflexive or emphatic. Okay, if the last pronoun is referring back to the first pronoun, then blindly we need to understand that it is nothing but our reflexive. And one pronoun is followed by other pronoun immediately, then we need to understand that it is nothing but our emphatic. It means the second pronoun is emphasizing on the first one. Okay, and now coming to the next one, demonstrative pronoun, like the words which we use for demonstrating a product, like this, that, these, those, they, these are all nothing but our demonstrative pronouns. And coming to the distributive pronoun, each, either, neither, these are the three words, I mean these are the three pronouns which we consider under a distributive pronoun. And coming to the next one, interrogative, the name itself is saying, interrogative means asking questions. When we use these WH words, HOW, like these words, we are going to consider them as interrogative pronouns. And coming to the next one, indefinite, indefinite, it means when we are not sure. We use these type of words, some, few, little, more, much, many. These are some of the examples of our indefinite pronouns. And coming to the next one, reciprocal, one another, each other. These are the two pronouns which comes under reciprocal pronoun. And coming to the relative pronoun, we use these words like who, which, that, whom. These are some of our relative pronoun. And why do we use a relative pronoun here? If you want to combine two clauses which has some relationship with each other, and instead of using two sentences, if you want to combine them, and if you want to make one single sentence, in that case we are supposed to use these relative pronouns. Okay, so once again it's a reminder from my side, just listening to the class, all right, and looking at this board, you may get some sort of knowledge. But the thing is, continuous practice, all right, continuous practice makes you perfect in these grammar topics. So that is the reason why if you have textbooks, just open your textbooks, try to read something, and whenever you come across any of these words, immediately you need to identify what type of pronoun it is. Because even in your examination, they will give you some sentences, and in those sentences they will underline some words, and we are supposed to identify the parts of speech. All right, so for that reason, compulsory you need to have an idea what all pronouns are. So these are different types of pronouns, and these are the words which comes under pronouns. So you need to have an idea. Okay, so that's it for today dear, and in the next class we shall come up with the next new parts of speech, that is nothing but verb. So tomorrow we shall discuss about the verb. Okay, that's it for today. Okay, take care. See you tomorrow.